Kindly open ka open cam class. Open cam.
Sir, off mic po kayo, sir.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening, sir.
Okay.
Good evening, sir.
Sige.
Good evening, sir.
Miss ko na kayo.
Good evening, sir.
Yes, yes. Yes, Mr. Charles. Nag-wave ka? Nag-raise ka?
Ay, sir. Ano po? May tanong lang po ako, sir, tungkol sa ano? Yung sinend mo po na video kagabi.
Oo nga, hindi ko nag-play kasi may sinama kasi akong mga video clip doon na from YouTube. Kaya hindi ko pa nasisend. Isisend ko pa lang mamaya. So yun dapat yung discussion natin kahapon. It's all about the history, from biblical history of intelligence to the modern history of intelligence. But anyways, pwedeng ano, may na-record na ako, pwedeng yun na lang ang isend ko. Para hindi tayo magahul sa oras. Mamaya, isend ko mamaya. Any other questions? Open cam tayo. O bakit ganyan ang ngiti mo, ano na to?
Nanibago lang po ako, sir. Ano? Kalbo na po ako ngayon.
Ako nga eh. How about the others? Bakit naman yung mga foreheads nyo ang pinapakita nyo? Anin ba natin yan? So, ganyan dapat yung buong mukha. Nantok ba kayo?
Sir, no sir.
No sir.
Okay, so let's resume. Allow me to share my screen. Banana. So this was the presentation which I sent you yesterday. Ayan. Anyways, isi-send ko na lang ulit mamaya. It's all about the history, historical development of intelligence from biblical history to the modern history. And we also discussed here the different intelligence units worldwide. Anyways, we can still move on, and you'll just watch this video later. So this is our topic allotted for this day, the intelligence during the World Wars. So during the World War One, from 1914 to 1918, we have the assassination of Archduke Franz Ferdinand. Intelligence during this period concentrated on information about the armed forces of the enemy and their capabilities. So ganun ang nangyayari ng mga ng World War One. If you know the strength of your enemy armed forces and their capabilities, then of course you will know how to combat those. And if you know also the weaknesses of your enemy country, then you know where to strike them, di ba? Alam mo kung saan sila, alam mo yung weak point nila, alam mo kung paano sila mapapatumba. So from 1914 to 1918, we have our aircraft introduced as method of conducting aerial reconnaissance. So when you say aerial reconnaissance, he gathers the topography of our territory. So yan, during the World War One, aircraft were used to gather topography. So ano bang purpose ng topography? It draws the map. So pagka namapa kayo ng target ay ng kalaban yung bansa, eh nagplaplano na sila kung paano kayo lulusubin. We also have here the wireless telegraph. It was used It was used with codes and ciphers. So when we say codes and ciphers, these are means of hiding the true meaning of a communication. So Morse code. Yun, alam niyo ba yung Morse code? Yung tit 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 tat tat tat, mga ganyan. Papakinggan lang ng mga nag-aral noon, alam na yung ibig niya sabihin. Mayroon ng mga sentence o paragraph na nabuo doon just because of that Morse code. And ciphers naman work in the way that if a certain communication states, Albert, is the spy. Pagka ganun naman yung message na gustong ipabahagi, ang gagawin ngayon ng intelligence officer to cipher that, to itago yung content ng message na yun, is depende kung ano yung pinag-usapan nilang cipher means. So pwedeng yung letter C is i-adjust nila ng 5 letters. So instead of letter C ay letter A, Albert, ang gagawin is A, B, C, D, E. So magiging E yung A. Tapos yung L plus 4 letters. L, M, N, O, P. So magiging P. So EP. Parang ganun. Yung instead of Albert, EP. So pagka nabasa ng kalaban yun, hindi nila alam kung anong ibig sabihin nun. Pero pagka yung mga ka-team nyo ang nakakuha ng information na yun, alam nila kung paano i-decipher yung message. So, instead of EP so-and-so, ang mababasa nila is Albert is the spy. So, nabasa nila, na-decipher nila yung hidden message. During the German intelligence, gained a high reputation for offensive effectiveness throughout Europe, but declined at the outset of war. So, Europe known German to be offensive and effective intelligence. However, during the outset of war, pumalpak yung German intelligence. We also have here the British intelligence. It was succeeded greatly by means of censorship and its code room combined with skill use of covert agents. So, andito na naman yung word na censorship. When we say censorship, it is talking about the control of movement. So, when we say censorship, especially border censorship or postal censorship, mga yan, ang ibig niyang sabihin is bawal lumabas ng bansa ang mga Pilipino, parang ganyan, pagka in-implement sa Pilipinas. At bawal din ang mga China na pumasok sa territory ng Pilipinas. Pwede rin yung mga censorship ng goods. Bawal mag-export ng Philippine product and bawal din mag-import ng mga foreign products. Yan. And the advantage of censorship is that kung meron kayong, lalo na pagka nangunguna kayo sa technology, is that hindi kayo pwedeng gamitan or hindi pwedeng gamitin sa inyo or laban sa inyo yung technology na nagawa nyo or yung weapon na nagawa nyo. Yun ang purpose ng censorship, yun ang advantage ng censorship. Pagka kayo yung nangunang bansa. So, these are the images. And after World War I, followed your World War II. So, again, we also have, again, the German intelligence during the World War II. Started the war with the world's best organized intelligence service through advanced preparation of intelligence accompanied by troop movements. So, meron silang intelligence gathering. Nakapagplano sila. And habang nakapagplano sila, habang nagkakasa sila ng operasyon, they gather intelligence. So, sinasabay nila yung intelligence sa operation. And we know for a fact that intelligence-driven operation, again, is far more effective and efficient compared to just a plain military operation without intelligence, without planning at all. So, yan yung importance ng intelligence. So, you have here Hitler. And some of the weapons of your German enemy. Yan. Next to German, led by Hitler, with army called Nazis, yan, Nazi ang tawag sa army nila, followed British intelligence. So, these are the equipment used to receive Morse codes. So, yan, yung ginagamit nilang mag-communicate nung araw. Yan. They use this to intercept message and to communicate with other allies. So, pwede silang mag-intercept ng mga messages ng mga kalaban. Kumbaga, wiretap nila yung mga communication ng kalaban, and at the same time, they use this machine to relay information to their allies. And next to British intelligence is your Japanese intelligence. We have here the flag of the Japanese. The Japanese intelligence failed because it was not provided with sufficient number of trained personnel to assemble and evaluate the mass of materials which were collected. Although Japanese intelligence was involved in short war and defensive in nature. So, Japanese was defensive in nature during the World War II. When we say offensive, sila yung nananakop. When we say defensive, they defend their territory. Excuse me. So, these were the country na nasakop ng Japan during the World War II. Those colored in red. So, from this country, Japan, they were able to invade Korea, Manchuria, portion of China, Burma, Siam, French Indochina, Dutch East Indies, Philippines, of course, and New Guinea. So, yan yung mga nasakop ng Japan. We have here the attack on Pearl Harbor. And the Battle of Iwo Jima. So meron din tayong mga movies nito. Pearl Harbor and Iwo Jima. Ang naglaban dito is sa Philippines versus Japan. Asia versus Japan pala, na yung Asia tinulungan ng US. Tapos after that, US also invaded the countries na nagpatulong sa kanya. Wherein Philippines is one, di ba? So after tayong sinakop ng Japan, tinalo naman ng mga Amerikano yung Hapon, pero nasakop rin tayo ng Amerikano. So the Japanese surrender to the United States. So this is how Japanese soldiers looks like. So British intelligence, the delay in the use of German V-bomb against them was their main achievement during this time. So kung hindi na delay yung German V-bomb, talo sana sila, pero dahil sa na-delay yung napa-delay nila yung German V-bomb, then it became their greatest achievement during the World War II. So we also have the US intelligence during the World War II. In 1941, the US Strategic Service was established to research and analyze military, political, and economic information as it affected the security of the country. So yan yung mga naral ng intelligence ng US. They analyze military, that's first. Second is the political. And third is economic information. Now, this machine is in relation to economy. Paano nila mapapalago ang agriculture na mas mabilis? And this is in relation to military tanks and military radios. Communication. So that's it. Talunan lang natin to. Skip lang natin itong mga questions. So now, let's move on with the definition of intelligence. What is intelligence? According to the Webster Dictionary, intelligence is the capacity for understanding and for other forms of adaptive intellect behavior. It pertains to the mind in operation, that is intelligence. And the power of meeting any situation, especially a novel situation, successfully by proper behavior adjustment. So that is intelligence. It talks about proper behavior adjustments depending on situations. So, intelligence is the ability to apprehend or to understand the interrelationship of presented facts in such a way as to guide action towards the goal. So means to say, we use this intelligence information report in planning for our future goals. Intelligence is knowledge of an event. So yan, knowledge of histories, knowledge of circumstances, and of thinking capacity, which had been received or imparted. Yan. So these are knowledge of an event, circumstances, which have been received or imparted. When we say received, we received it from intelligence officers or from trusted sources, diba? Or imparted by other allies or trusted enforcers, agents. The gathering or distribution of information. So under your intelligence cycle, it involves the gathering up to the distribution of intelligence. Intelligence based on psychology is the capacity of a person to adjust to new situations through the use of what has been previously learned. So, you adjust based to situations by applying your learnings and experience in the past. So that is intelligence. According to the Government Commission Task Force, intelligence means the collection, processing, collation, interpretation, evaluation, and dissemination of information with reference to national security. And according to military terminologies, intelligence is the end product resulting from the following. So, from the process of collection of information, evaluation of this information, analysis of the information, integration of the information, and interpretation of information. So, every information gathered is processed hanggang sa makakuha tayo ng interpretation. And after we have interpreted the meaning of that information, we will now distribute the information for the use of proper authority. So, interpretation of all information which may have immediate or potential significance to the development and execution of plans, policies, and programs of the users. According to police parlance, the end product resulting from the collection, evaluation, analysis, interpretation, integration of all available information regarding the activities of criminal and other law violators for the purpose of effecting criminals and other law violators for their arrest, obtaining evidence, and forestalling plan to commit crime. So that is your intelligence according to police parlance. So any information about criminal activities. So we have here the broad categories of intelligence. So when we say broad categories of intelligence, napakalawak na category ng intelligence. So we have here the first national intelligence. National intelligence pertains or refers to the integrated product of intelligence developed by all government departments concerning the broad aspect of national policy and national security. So the purpose of national intelligence is for creation of national policy. When we say national policy, pwedeng creation of laws, yan, national law, and other national policies. And for the strengthening of our national security para hindi tayo madaling masakop ng mga mananakop, mga oppressors. Mapagtibay ang ating seguridad. Seguridad. Yan. That is the purpose of our national intelligence. Second is our Department Intelligence. So mas maliit yung department sa National Intelligence. Department Intelligence is that intelligence required by an agency or department of the government in order to execute its mission and discharge its responsibilities. So in the Philippines, what intelligence department do we have in the Philippines? We have
MICA, sir.
MICA, tama. Ano yung ibig sabihin ng MICA? Oh, wala na, hindi mo na alam. National Intelligence Coordinating Agency. So sila yung primary in charge with all the with the collation of all the intelligence from the different intelligence offices of the different government agencies. So merong intelligence report from the PNP, merong intelligence report from the AFP, merong intelligence report from the local government, lahat yan pinag-merge ng MICA. Third is our military intelligence. So is that intelligence used in the preparation and execution of military plans, policies, and programs. So simple lang naman, military intelligence is used for military plans, policies, and programs that aids in the success of military operations. So military intelligence, national intelligence, department intelligence, and military intelligence. So under military intelligence, it also has broad fields. So it has under its scope the strategic intelligence. So what is strategic intelligence? It is that knowledge pertaining to capabilities, vulnerabilities, and probable courses of action of foreign nations. So that is the strategic intelligence. So when we speak of capabilities, it refers to the ability of a nation to carry out its national objectives by virtue of its resources, technology, and the like. Yan. So inaaral ng strategic intelligence yung capabilities ng foreign nations. So ano ba yung kayang gawin ng foreign nations natin? Ang most threat natin ngayon na bansa is China. So ano ba yung mga capabilities ng China ngayon? What are their resources? What are their technology? What are their weapons? Diba? So ano yung mga kaya nilang gawin? Ano yung strengths nila? And vulnerabilities are the weaknesses which a nation is susceptible to in peace or in war. So ngayon, ano ba yung vulnerabilities naman ng China? Ano ba yung mga weaknesses nila? Meron ba silang weaknesses? Baka naman wala. How about their ties? Sino yung mga ties nila? Sino yung mga allies nila? May backup kaya sila pag in case manlaban ang Pilipinas with America, supported by America? So yun, vulnerabilities, all about weaknesses. Now, the probable courses of action naman refers to the courses of action open to a nation that may be adapted for accomplishing its national objectives. So, ano ba yung plan ngayon ng China? So, pwedeng sakupin niya yung Pilipinas, di ba? That's pwedeng isang plano niya yan. Ngayon, that is now considered a probable course of action of China against the Philippines. So, strategic intelligence, we have to determine the number of yan, kung ships ng British compared to ships ng French and Spanish. So French is blue and Spanish is yellow. So nag-joint force yung French and Spanish against the British fleet. So, syempre, pagka naglaban yung dalawang countries, ano ba yung mga basihan ng mga nananalo noong araw? So, kung sino yung mas marami, sila yung nananalo, di ba? Ganun. So, kung sinong mas advanced ang weapon, sila yung nananalo. And by the way, this is the example of your phalanx formation discussed on the video which I was which I sent you yesterday na hindi niyo napanood. So this is an example of the phalanx formation. Nakalinya sila. Ang una is the shield with the spears. Tapos dito sa may bandang likod nila is yung mga archers. So this is now your phalanx formation. We have here the phalanx. Tapos we also have here the archers and javeliners, yung mga nagbabato at namamana. And hipas pistay. We have here the right guard, left guard, and the reserve phalanx if in case na matalo yung unang phalanx. And the Persian infantries naman have their Greek mercenaries. They have their archers and their first line of attackers. So, strategic intelligence has different components. So, its components composed of the PETS bugs. So, ano ba yung PETS bugs? First is political. E stands for economic. T stands for transportation and telecommunication. S stands for sociological. B, biographic. A, armed forces. G, geographic or the map, topography, lat. S, scientific. So it includes researches and weapons. Yan. So we have here the tunnels of Kuchi. This is the Vietnam or the Viet Cong. The Vietnam Army against the American Army. We know for a fact that the Americans were defeated by the Vietnam. Diba? Kasi ang titignan mo naman, yung mga Vietnam, umatake yung mga US, hindi nila nakikita yung mga kalaban, wala silang nakikita ang kalaban, pero pagka nakakabanti na yung mga US troops dito, biglang magsisisulputan na from behind yung mga Viet Cong. So, maa-ambush na ngayon yung mga US troops. Yan. So, the Viet Cong acting as bait to lure Americans into the killing zone. So, meron din tayong mga Viet Cong na konti-konti na magpapakita sa mga Amerikano tapos magpapahabol. Ayun, pag nagpahabol ngayon yung Viet Cong sa mga US, mapupunta ngayon yung US sa ambush area. So, pag napunta na sa ambush area, saka na sila sabay-sabay na kapuputokan ng Viet Cong. So, B stands for the machine gun to begin infrared fire from fighting bunker, one strap is sprung. So, ito yung mga B, mga machine gunners. C is claymore mine operators. When we say claymore mines, ito yung mga nagpapasabog ng claymore mines. So, pagka nandito na yung US, tapos may plantang claymore dito, pag pwedeng matrigger through apak, pag naapakan nila, or pwedeng through wire. Pwedeng kinokontrol ng Viet Cong. So, pwedeng through wire. D is the hidden machine gun sighted to sweep killing zone. So, D. So, meron pa siyang hidden machine gun dito. D. E, sniper moving into position. So, asan yung letter E? Ah, so ito yung sniper natin, moving into position, E. And F pertains to the tunnel rat. So, ito naman yung tunnel rat nila. Kita niyo yung design? Tunnel rat. So, the Viet Cong has their stock room. Meron din silang hospital inside the tunnel room. Meron din silang well, source of water. Meron din silang kitchen, pinaglulutuan. Meron din silang baby trap and false tunnel. Tapos meron din silang, of course, air shaft para makahinga sila sa loob. Yan, air shaft. And the fighting bunker. Saan sila magtatago habang pumuputok. So that is your Viet Cong versus Army. So next to strategic intelligence, we also have here combat intelligence. Combat intelligence is used in planning and conducting tactical and administrative operations. So we have here your keyword, tactical. So combat intelligence refers to tactical and administrative operations. Yan. So, combat intelligence used in planning and conducting tactical administrative operations. So, what are the components of combat intelligence? We also have PWET. So, PETSBAG ang components ng strategic intelligence. Si combat intelligence is PWET. So, what is PWET? The people, weather, enemy, and terrain. So, ito yung mga components ng combat intelligence. Before they operate, dapat alam nila yung people. So, ano yung mga ano yung strength ng mga kalaban doon? Gaano sila karami? Ano yung weather condition? Babagyo kaya o maaraw? Kasi kung babagyo, baka matalo tayo. Enemy. So, gaano karami yung enemy? And the terrain. Ano ba yung mga dadaanan natin? Masukal ba? Open area ba? Or closed area ba? Kasi kung open area, prone tayo sa ambush. Mga ganyan, di ba? So, dapat aralin yung terrain. And you have here the image of the Spartan 300. So, till 300 lang sila, but they were able to defeat this thousand of Persians. Di ba? Spartans 300. Kaya lang naman natalo yung Spartan 300 because of the traitor na nagturo nitong daan sa likod. But without that traitors, kayang-kayang talunin ng Spartan 300 lahat yan. Sana. And next to combat intelligence, we have the counterintelligence. So what does it mean when we hear the word counterintelligence? Ano bang ibig niya sabihin? Counterintelligence denies information to the enemy. So means to say, we hide the information to the enemy. Increases the security of the command and aids in achieving surprise. Yan. So most importantly, hide the information to the enemy. So we have active and passive measures of counterintelligence. When we say passive measures, it pertains to the secrecy discipline. So ano ba ang secrecy discipline? Kung meron kayong ROTC, di ba? What you see, what you hear, when you leave, leave it here. Di ba? Yan ang secrecy discipline. Kung ano yung mga natutunan nyo dito, ano yung nalaman nyo dito, ano yung mga nakita nyo, pag lumabas kayo, huwag niyong sasabihin sa labas, dito lang. Pagka sinabi niyo sa labas, baka it will threaten the security of our security. Yan. So, meron din tayong security of classified information. So, ano ba yung security of classified information? Meron tayong classification of securities of information. Meron tayong yung secret, top secret, confidential, restricted. Diba? So, it is a means of passive measures. So, when we say a top secret, only those top secret certified personnel can have access to that information. Hindi pwedeng malaman ng walang top secret clearance. Yan. So, top secret yung pinakamataas, followed by secret, followed by confidential, and restricted. So, we also have the movement control. Diba, ang isang example ng movement control is bawal kayong lumabas, mga ganyan, diba? O kaya, unauthorized person, keep out. Mga ganyan. Yan yung mga movement control. And camouflage. So, yung pagsusot ng camouflage is a passive measure of security. So, the more na naka-camouflage ka, the more na hindi ka makikita. While active measures of counterintelligence includes counter-reconnaissance, counter-espionage, counter-sabotage, and counter-subversion. So, means to say, when we say counter-reconnaissance, merong nagre-recon na spy ng kalaban, ngayon, kina-counter-reconnaissance natin, nilalabanan natin. So, the more na tinatago natin, o gumagawa tayo ng peking daan, yan, mga peking information. Now, yun ang binabato natin sa mga espionage, sa mga sabotage, sa mga subversion agent ng kalaban. Yan ang trabaho ng ayan ang ibig sabihin ng active measures of counterintelligence. The active act of hiding informations against the enemy. So, counter-reconnaissance, tinatago natin yung mapa natin. Counter-espionage, tinatago natin yung mga important information natin. Yung counter-sabotage naman is pinoprotectionan natin yung mga important or mga necessary installations natin, such as the communication facilities, yung mga yan, yung mga electricity company. Pagka yan ay sinabotahin ng kalaban natin, hindi na tayo makakapag-communicate. Pag hindi na tayo nakapag-communicate, madali na tayong masasakop. Yan. And counter subversion, yung mananakop, anti-spies within our organization. So we have here principle of intelligence operations. We have general. Intelligence operations are influenced by elements of the operational environment. It includes the commander's mission, limitation imposed by the national policy or higher commands, scale of use of nuclear and other weapons, the local, the nature of friendly and enemy forces, and the civil population in the area. So, dapat lahat yan inaalam natin in general. So, the population of the local, the weapons of all the enemy, the location of our friendly forces, and the civil population. So, commander's need. Intelligence must fit the needs of the commander. So, kung yung commander, ang tanong ng commander is, what is the strength of our enemy? Gaano ba sila kadami? Yun ang tanong. Tapos, yung intelligence na binato is, yung mga kalaban ay nasa bulubundukin. Yun yung binabato. It does not answer the commander's need. So, hindi naaayon sa commander's need yung intelligence na binabato. Dapat ang binabato is, ang sagot is, the enemy is composed of thousands or hundreds. Tapos, dapat mas specific pa, o saan ba nakabase yung mga hundreds na yan? o kung saan sila nakabase, saan sila distributed. Dapat ganun. Different commanders need information or different geographic areas. Some of their needs, however, are from overlapping areas. Plans, orders, and requests are concerned with definite areas, particularly the area of influence of the command. So, planning. Intelligence requires careful and thorough planning. So, even the acquisition of intelligence needs planning. It includes the anticipation of intelligence needs. So, under planning, dapat iniisip din natin, pinagplanuhan din natin yung mga pangangailangan natin ng intelligence. In case, there's an upcoming war between US and China. So, ano pa kayong mga pangangailangan natin? O ano pa kaya, saan kaya natin kakailanganin ng intelligence? O ano kaya, yung mga kakailanganin nating impormasyon na pwede nating mapag-deployan ng ating mga intelligence officers? That's how we anticipate the need of intelligence. So, after the planning, we also have to use intelligence must be adequate for the purpose for which it is to be utilized. So, dapat yung intelligence is must be used to which it is to be utilized. Yan. And timeliness. Intelligence must reach the user in time to serve as basis for appropriate action. Yan. Useless ang intelligence nyo kung hindi naman siya reported on time during that day na kailangan. Eh, pagka late mong nireport yung intelligence mo, panis na. Wala nang tulong yan. Wala nang value yan. Hindi na nakatulong. Kung kailan talo na tayo sa kamong binapir information, dapat nung may pag-asa pa. Diba? Mga ganyan. Timeliness. Patay na yung kabayo sa kamo binibigyan ng maraming damo. Useless. Flexibility. Intelligence activities are based on reason and judgment and not on fixed procedure. So, intelligence really is flexible. So, it depends on the situation. Yan. Security. Constant security measures must be undertaken to deny unauthorized personnel information about operations, sources or information and intelligence product. So, kaya nga tayo merong security classification. Diba? Para yung mga authorized persons lang ang maka-access sa depende sa klase ng information na yun. And imagination, foresight, and resourcefulness. One must be able to take the initiative in anticipating the steps or actions of the enemy. One should be able to foretell its probable courses of action. So, ano kaya yung magiging courses of action ng kalaban natin? An integral part of military operations. Intelligence activities are integral parts of the operations of all units, both combat and service. So, continuity. Of course, the basic principle of intelligence operations is that intelligence activities follow a simple continuous cycle. So, dapat yung intelligence gathering natin is continuous yan. Hindi porque nakagather na tayo ng intelligence ngayon, titigil na tayo. Hindi. Because dynamic nga yan eh. Yung mga kalaban natin, nag-upgrade din sila. So, every update ng kalaban, dapat nasusundan din natin. Dapat continuous ang intelligence gathering natin. So, we have here the intelligence as a cycle. All intelligence activities generally follow a four-phase cycle oriented to the commander's mission. Yeah, so, time check, it's already 7 p.m. Do you have questions? So, there being none, ladies and gentlemen, andyan pa ba kayo?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Nakita ko kasi yung syllabus natin. Ano eh, duhol tayo sa oras. Kaya medyo binibilisan ko lang para makahabol. So, next meeting, we will be talking about the uses of intelligence. Saan ba ginagamit ang intelligence? And a record of this discussion will be sent to you later, together with the record of our discussion yesterday. Yan, yung record sana natin supposedly yesterday. We'll send to later. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your participation. Let's call it a night.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, po, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, po, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, yes.